Oracle Cloud APM provides these options for loading data: data integration for complex data mappings, REST APIs and EPM Automate, lifecycle management using artifact snapshots, and the import-export utility. I'll be loading data into planning modules using the import-export utility. If you would like to learn how to load data into other planning application types, view the exporting and importing data in planning tutorial. The link is listed in the description. You will need a data file for each artifact or data intersection you want to import. Source data must be in a planning or S-based data file format and saved as a CSV or text file using valid delimiters. You can create the source data file manually, generate one based on the source system, then update it, or download and modify a module's data load template. Make sure that the required metadata must already exist in the planning cubes and in the S-based outline before you load the application data. To generate a data file from the source system, you use the import-export utility. You export data based on a data point of view. Learn more about exporting data in the Exporting and Importing Data in Planning video tutorial. The link is listed in the description. To download data load templates for planning modules, navigate to the Configure page. You can download data load templates for financials, workforce, capital, and projects. The templates are generated based on the features you've enabled and the custom dimensions that you added when you enabled features. For descriptions of data load templates available in each module, see Appendix B, Importing Data, of the Administering Planning Modules documentation. In the Actions menu of the module you selected, click Download Data Load Templates. Save the zip file to a local folder and then extract its contents. Data source files must contain a header record, and then below the header record, a list of data records that you want to import or modify. When you have your data source file ready, open the Import Data utility and create an Import Data job. I'll first show you how to import from a locally stored file. For location, make sure you select Local. Select if you are importing a planning or S-based formatted data source file. Default refers to your Cloud EPM business process. Select whether you are loading a comma-delimited CSV file or a tab-delimited text file. If you are loading a text file using other supported delimiter characters, select Other. You can find a list of other supported delimiter characters in the Administering Planning documentation. Next, select your data source file. For best practices, clear include metadata to prevent members from changing position in the outline during data import. You can select the date format used in your file. As a precaution, always validate your data files before running the import process. Check the status of the validation process in jobs. If errors are found, make sure to review the job results and modify your data source file as needed. When the validation displays as completed with no errors, return to the Import Data utility and re-enter your selections. Then, proceed with running the import job. The import data process may take a moment to complete. Navigate to Jobs and check if the data imported successfully. Now, if you want to import using a data file on the server, you'll first need to upload your data file. Go to Inbox Outbox Explorer and click Upload. Select the file you want to upload. When the upload completes, the file is listed in the Inbox Outbox Explorer. You'll need the file name when you create the import data job. Return to the import data utility and create an import data job. This time, for location, select Inbox. Select your source and file type. In source file, type the complete file name of the data source file you uploaded to the server. Review or modify your job selections, then click Save As Job. This allows you to run this job anytime after you save it. Enter a name for the job and error zip file. The job is saved and listed in the Import Data dialog. You can modify the job and save your changes. Using the Actions menu, you can delete, submit the job for processing, or save a copy of the job. After you submit the Import Data job, you can review its status in Jobs. You can also schedule the Import Data job to run later. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.